Bone Crusher, Mr. Never Scared, Mr. Outstanding, and that's my man from the crush say, Mr. Macaroni and Cheese. Yeah. You're rolling right now with the crush, and it's going down, man. Sports? Yes. Talk? Indeed.
Welcome everybody to Rolling Out with the Crush, where sports meets entertainment. I am your humble co-host, E. Glaze. And with me as always is my guy, make sure you heard. What's happening, Herb?
I'm good, brother. What's happening?
Hey man, we got us a special guest in
the Lord have mercy.
Please give this man his proper introduction.
Listen, man, this man needs no introduction. Not at all. But I'm gonna give it to him anyway. Atlanta legend, man. Bone Crusher. What's up, my dude?
Fellas. Life is wonderful. I'm here to talk sports. Let's debate.
Okay. And we're going to start with the debate. Oh, Monday, January 8th, in the Big Body Benz.
Yep.
Georgia Bulldogs.
Mm-hmm.
Alabama Crimson Tide.
Yep.
Who you like? Let's start it off, Bone Crusher.
I mean, I like Georgia. I mean, you can never dispute Alabama and the greatness of that team, man. Nick Saban has always got them boys ready. But I tell you one thing about Georgia, man. Georgia has proven over the last few games that they are never going to stop coming, and they have a lot of luck. And this is home field advantage for them at Mercedes Stadium.
Major.
I'm going to go with Georgia 20-17.
I like that. What you got, mate?
I like that. Listen, the more I keep looking at this, these two teams and the matchup, I just don't see how Alabama can score enough points. Mm-hmm. If you look at what they did against Clemson, right. You look at Jalen Hurts all season.
Yeah.
Jalen Hurts, he's like he's regressed.
Yeah.
Alabama's very one-dimensional offensively. Georgia has proven that, listen, we thought that he could play a shootout.
Right.
They went toe-to-toe with a high-powered
right.
team.
Right.
I don't know if Alabama has enough offense to keep up with Georgia. I like Georgia.
I do too, simply because I think Georgia's going to make Hurts' arm beat him.
Oh, but yeah.
Can he throw good enough?
No.
Negative.
To beat a team?
No.
I think Georgia's going to put them big boys, you know, I got Roquan going to be in there. He's going to stop that running game.
Yeah. Say,
okay, Jalen.
Do Beatles. Your thing.
Beatles in the air.
Right.
Yeah, you got Ridley, but that's it. We're going to stick one guy on there. We show that he can't do much.
Even the call.
But let me ask y'all this, though. Even though we know, can Kirby get over the fact that his mentor is across the field in Nick Saban? Right. Will that play a part in it?
I think so. I think that, you know, for what we've seen of him, he makes great adjustments at halftime. He's been doing that all season. And I think that even if Alabama get up on him, I think that he's going to make the proper adjustments in the locker room at halftime and come out and really show why Georgia Bulldogs and Georgia football is something to be reckoned with.
Mm. He makes a good point because we saw Kirby Mayfield do adjustments against Oklahoma.
Yep.
Major.
It was two different halves.
Right.
So it looks like he has that pedigree that, you know, nothing against Mark Rick, that is different than what Georgia is used to.
Mm-hmm. Right.
He can go into halftime and say, yo, all we got to do is cut this off, motivate, because he motivated Raquan to come out and have a whole different second half.
Right. Yep.
So I think he may have it. What's your thoughts?
I totally agree with Bone one more time. This is the thing. They're making a big deal about all of his assistants. He's 11-0.
11-0 against his assistants. Right.
His assistants have never had a team that Kirby has.
Real talk.
When you look at this Georgia team, and you think back to a lot of the other Alabama teams, this team is built just like those Alabama teams. This is what made Kirby special. Mm-hmm. Kirby was able to get the blueprint because he was there longer than everybody else. A lot of his assistants were there 1 or 2 years, then when he got jobs.
Right.
Kirby was there.
Right.
And Kirby really, what people don't give Kirby credit for, he actually was Alabama's top recruiter.
Yeah.
So he built a lot of Alabama's program. So Georgia, they mirror images of each other. So Kirby will get the nod on this one.
So you hear from us, rolling out with the crush, when I got Bone Crusher. Unanimous. We all got Georgia winning in the Big Body Benz. Real quick though, how crazy this city gonna be this week?
Oh man, it's already crazy. We stayed out of town, so it's already crazy.
Right.
Oh, it's already. I mean, the teams are no longer. I mean, Alabama, what, 3 hours from Atlanta?
3 hours.
Georgia, an hour.
Right.
Everybody in this area, it's like, even though it's a national championship, it's like the SEC championship.
Yeah, right. You know what I mean? So right.
Big, everything. It's just going to be crazy this week. I'm telling y'all, if you're in Atlanta, either you go stay big, go big or go home.
That's real.
Because it's going to be huge this weekend. All the pump and circumstance. So we're going to talk about something else, though. Still talking about this weekend. NFL playoffs start this weekend, fellas.
Yeah.
Wild card season, and we're going to go through all four of them, but we're going to start with the ATL last because I want to get our true opinion. But let's start with the team that's right across the next state going to our rivals in Atlanta, the New Orleans Saints.
Mm-hmm.
Carolina, New Orleans.
Mm-hmm.
Who do y'all like in that game? We'll start with that one. BoneCrusher, who you got?
You can never count on Drew Brees. I mean, Brees is one of the greatest quarterbacks that ever played a game, but, you know, Cam Newton, it's something about Carolina and New Orleans. It seems like, you know, Carolina usually has the ticket, just how New Orleans usually got ours.
Right.
You know, Carolina with Cam, you know, and even with the tight end, what's his name, Olsen?
Olsen, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Tight end Olsen, he's gonna have a big game. He got a big game against New Orleans. He came from New Orleans.
Yeah.
So he's going to have a big game against them. And I think, man, I don't know. Man, I hope they beat New Orleans. We can beat Carolina. You know what I'm talking about? We can beat the Panthers. You know what I mean? So I'm going with Carolina Panthers.
Yeah, man. So
Cam Newton, where you at, man? Where you at?
What you got, Mace? This game, in almost every game with Carolina, I always say this, it comes down to Cam Newton.
It's about Cam.
Yeah.
When Cam is focused and when Cam is tuned into the game, he's unstoppable.
Yeah, he is. Yeah.
But when Cam get in Cam mode,
that's a wrap.
Oh man, he getting his feelings.
Yeah, getting a little sensitive.
Oh man,
start slamming the ball.
They have to start fast. Once he put that towel over his head and start, you know, that little thing that Cam does.
Pop.
Right. That's when you start worrying. The thing I like about New Orleans. With Kamara and Ingram running that football.
Yeah.
It looks like they've added 5 years to Drew Brees' career.
Yeah.
With the game being in New Orleans, I'm going New Orleans. Just because I don't know which Cam will show up.
Yeah.
Just because I don't know which
Cam will show up. Level Bay, New Orleans will win the game. But I really hope. I really, really hope Carolina beat the Saints. Come on, Carolina!
And I don't want to show my pettiness in because I hope the same thing.
Right.
But I don't know if we got to. If it was 2015, Cam.
Yeah.
MVP Cam.
Yeah.
Like I said, no doubt. This Fedora Cam. This skinny jeans.
Fedora Cam.
I don't know if we're going to get greatness or frustration.
Such a moody guy.
Only because it's in the. Y'all won't have the big body bins in New Orleans. Y'all got the small bins.
Yeah.
E-class. It's the big body up here, so we in that.
Maybach.
Yeah.
Maybach.
The Maybach. Since y'all in the small bins, I take New Orleans in the small bins.
You don't want to do it.
I don't want to do it. It hurts.
Yeah,
but being a pro and a professional, and we all a professional gentlemen up here.
That's right.
That's probably where we see it. Another game that's going to be interesting. Buffalo travels to Kansas City and Arrowhead. Kansas City said, you know what? All that cuteness we were doing before, we're back to running the football right now with Hill.
Running college offense.
Arrowhead's going to be crazy. One of the craziest stadiums in the NFL. Give me guys your opinion on that game.
Kansas City going to beat the brakes off.
I ain't going to be agreeing with you.
Kansas City going to beat Buffalo like they stole something. And it's going to be a bad game for Buffalo. But I tell you what, though. Buffalo, great city.
Yeah.
I've been there several times. Man, great wings. I haven't eaten chicken in a while, but it's great wings. Man, they have amazing fans. But
very amazing.
But, you know, so does Kansas City and Arrowhead. And, you know, what I do know is that Buddy Ryan's going to be ready. That's all I can say.
Blowout City, what you got, Mace?
Yeah, Kansas City, they should get back on track. It's wonderful to see Buffalo finally back in the playoffs. It's been almost 20 years that they're back. I hate it's not in Buffalo.
Right.
You know, the weather, their fans. Buffalo Buffalo had the best fans in the NFL.
They do.
Bar none. Yeah. You know, they set each other on fire.
Next to the Bears. The Bears got the
Yeah. You know.
Something like that cold weather.
Yeah, you know, Buffalo Bills fan, they jumping off tables, DDTing people.
Yeah.
But saying all that, Kansas City gonna win this game.
Yeah.
Kansas City gonna win.
I like to phrase that. Bone said, beat the brakes off.
Yeah. That's ATL term.
Yeah. It took 18 years for y'all to get out, it's gonna take 1 week for y'all to leave.
Yeah. Enjoy the week, Buffalo.
Get it on, man.
Take the playoff favorite. It's Sunday. It's time for playoff. Enjoy the song. It's a great song for you guys. A great set.
Another game we're going to go through real quick. Jacksonville, Tennessee. Jacksonville is in the playoffs after over 20 years.
Yeah.
Hosting a home game.
Yeah, man.
But they still have Blake Bortles at quarterback. Tennessee, we don't think which college is playing this week in running back.
Yeah.
DeMarco Murray's out.
DeMarco Murray's out. Yeah. So it's going to be on the big fella. I think Jacksonville wins. They win their first playoff in a while because I just don't think Tennessee has enough. But I want to hear from you guys. What you guys think? Bone?
Man, I think Jacksonville has proven themselves in a short span to go from terrible to outstanding that they are a force to be reckoned with right now.
Right.
And I think they might get the win, man. Who knows? They ain't never been to the playoffs, so I think they... I mean, from what I can tell from them playing all season, a little bit about watched of that team, they've proven to me that they are definitely a team that's on the rise. And that owner has spent a lot of money on that team. He's dead serious about that team.
Right.
You know, he's a borderline small time off the blank, so they may squeeze out the victory.
Uh-huh. What you got, Mike?
Yeah. It's hard to take Tennessee.
Yeah.
Just because of they don't have no weapons. Like I don't know the receivers.
Yeah, Mariota, that's it.
Yeah, Mariota. Mariota had been as good as we thought. You know, him and Jameis. I know Jameis not a player, but you know, they were 1-2 together, yeah. So you kinda were like, okay, this gonna be neither one of them had kinda like really panned out. I love the Jacksonville defense, you know.
Yeah, their defense is crazy, bro.
I almost jumped off of Top of Sweet Lounge because I wanted Jalen Ramsey in Dallas.
And I like Dallas
Ramsey.
Man, I feel sorry.
Yeah. With BoneCrusher saying all that, I'm taking Jacksonville.
I'm taking Jacksonville too because I think they're going to give Fournette at least 25 to 30 carries.
Run the ball.
Yeah. And I think he's going to run the ball.
Run the ball.
Down they throw.
And then that defense is going to hold the lead.
Right.
And if Mariota can't throw with them corners they got down there, it might be one of them. But it's going to be weirdly tight, though. You know, it's going to be one of them games. You'll be like, man, this should be as close.
Right.
But it's close.
Right.
Because
not going to be good to watch on TV.
Yeah,
that's one of them games that you can kind of follow on Twitter, go run your errands. It's going to be one of those.
Catch up with.
Yeah.
All right, guys. I say that not everybody's Atlanta Falcons.
Yeah.
Atlanta Falcons travel across the country.
3,000 miles.
To L.A. to face Todd Gurley and the L.A. Rams.
People say Gurley the MVP.
You know what? That's a good conversation.
People say that.
One Georgia team has already traveled to L.A. and made a victory. Will another Georgia team do the same thing this Saturday at 4:25? BoneCrusher, who you got, Atlanta or the L.A. Rams, man?
Man, I'm always going with the Falcons. Let me tell you something about the Falcons, man. The Falcons are the type of team that will have you have a heart attack, they'll stress you out.
Yeah.
One thing I do know about the Falcons, man, is that they are always good at high-profile games.
Mm.
They are always good. Then they'll lose to the Cleveland Browns, but they will beat the brakes off of Green Bay Packers. So you get that type of extreme with the Falcons, right? Mm-hmm. So they go into L.A., they have proven that they are a team to be reckoned with, even though this team isn't as, well, I won't say, this team isn't as good as last year, of course not.
Right.
But they have the same team.
Yeah.
You know, it's all about the motivation of the team itself. If they get out there and they jump up on them, it's a wrap.
Yeah.
LA hasn't been to the playoffs.
Yeah.
So the Falcons get up on them, it's a wrap. And let me tell you something about Matt Ryan. Matty Broken Ice. Matt Ryan, if he get on a roll and if he can sit back there and ain't nobody hitting him, he will destroy you.
Yeah.
He will destroy you, man. Julio Jones, man, and that damn running, that running game come out that backfield, you forget about it.
Yeah.
If they get up on him, Falcons by 2 touchdowns.
Maceo, listen. This is a game that Atlanta Falcons should truly win.
Well, clearly.
When you talk about rookie coach,
yeah,
second year quarterback,
right.
Yeah.
The playoffs, what we know about the playoffs, it's a different season.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Everything you did in the regular season, throw it out the window.
Yeah.
Just throw it out.
0-0, you in.
Yeah. The Falcons have enough experience. I think the struggles of the Falcons this season was more or less they were pressing. We just need to get in the playoffs.
Yeah.
We just need to get in the playoffs. The only wild card is Steve Sarkisian.
Mm-hmm.
Can he dial up a good enough game plan to keep the Rams off balance?
Yeah.
As long as the game stay close, Falcons win this game.
Mm-hmm.
Can't let the Rams get that fast start.
Right.
Yeah. Trick plays, Gurley on a long run. Because the thing we know about L.A., Fairweather fans, they're not going to really be into it. You know, they're going to be Snapchatting. Yeah. And
drinking Avion.
Yeah, right. All that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah,
Avion drinkers.
Right. So, I like the Falcons. I like the Falcons on Saturday night.
The great thing about the Rams, they're young. The bad thing about the Rams,
they're young.
Right. So, with that being said, I think it's going to be a good one. I think it'll be actually a good game. I think the Falcons win just because of, like you said, it's a new season.
Yeah.
Falcons have traveled. They understand it. What will Jared Goff do with pressure?
Oh, yeah.
This bring is pressure.
It.
It's, one it's one and done now. You don't have it next week. You lose
right.
this week.
Bring it.
It's over. So here's what I'm expecting to see. I don't know if I'm right or not. Falcons going to try to load the box against Gurley.
Mm-hmm. Got to stop that first.
And see if Goff can be with them.
Right.
Just like I was saying with the whole Alabama-Georgia thing.
Right.
Can Goff, does he have enough in that arm
mm-hmm.
to beat this squad? Because I think you have to load up the box to beat them. On the other side, the Falcons do still got Julio. They still got that running back tandem.
Yeah.
You would think the explosion may happen.
Right, yeah.
Because now all the pressure, because
they're due.
All the pressure of not being, you know, nobody's ever made 28-3. Nobody ever made the playoffs after they've lost the Super Bowl.
Yeah,
it's over with.
Yeah,
it's over with. It's time to play football. But I don't think the Rams no punk, but I think there will be some Avion Ward in the stadium. So we'll see.
I mean, the Falcons, man, are messing around and win the Super Bowl just because nobody think they can do it. Last year, man, everybody was like, the Falcons win the Super Bowl. They were supposed to win the Super Bowl.
Right.
But, you know.
Totally agree.
Yeah, but the whole thing about it is that the Falcons, once again, it's about ownership and the actual coach, that head coach, they like the head coach. I don't know how much they like the offensive coordinator, but they are a force to be reckoned with. They keep winning games, man. They lose one, and they win three. They lose one, and now they're 10-6.
Yeah.
You know, who would have thought they'd be 10-6?
Right.
I don't know, man. The Falcons, man, they mess around and get the Super Bowl, man, because they that crazy.
They could have slipped in there and did stuff like
that. They could have slipped in there and won it, and nobody would even know they won it.
Y'all believe, like, I ain't.
They, man, I don't know how they won it, though.
But I'm telling y'all right now, if something like that happened, Jordan win the national championship, Falcons win,
it's over.
Jordan, you explode. The state would explode.
They open 112, man.
You know what I'm trying to tell you?
Atlanta Live, all that. Everybody coming back.
Everything's back.
Everything reopened. We right. back.
Buckhead, back World Boy, everything.
We got Keisha Lance bottles, man. We might as well go ahead and get some more victory.
Let's get it. Hey, real quick, guys, I want to ask y'all about something with the NBA. Isaiah Thomas is back.
Yeah.
He played his first game, and he's going to
see. Boston has proven that they ain't scared of nobody. Right. They ain't no punk. Right. Now, they are 36-10.
Yeah, something like that. They were ridiculous.
Yeah, they got a better record than Cleveland.
Yeah,
they beat the brakes off last night. Even with Isaiah Thomas in there, they were lost. So it's just like I think that Boston is the biggest threat for Cleveland, and nobody's a threat for Golden State. Nobody.
I'm almost gonna co-sign with that because when you look at this is why Clay is not gonna leave.
Man, Clay got one more year of good Paul. He gonna go get that change.
You know, NBA is guaranteed, so he can all that.
Yeah. Nobody has enough to beat Golden State.
They just,
you know, barring injury.
Yeah, they had to have two or three.
They should walk through the playoff. Because when you look at the West, nobody.
Houston ain't doing that.
No, Houston might, man.
He's playing, but what they have to do, okay, we give y'all minutes together.
Yeah.
Then it's James Harden's show. Yeah. Then it's Chris Paul's show. That's not going to work in the playoffs.
I have to agree. Golden State.
When Golden State.
Even when Steph went down, he was like,
we good.
Yeah.
Swaggy P.
Swaggy P playing great.
Whoever. Yeah, like you said, tonight somebody. Roscoe Jenkins.
Man, they got dudes that start that were starting on other teams on the bench.
Right.
Like
right.
us just sitting here.
Right. Coach Kurt, I give you 10.
I give you 10. So man, that's the sports section, man. We gotta talk about our guy BoneCrusher, man. Bone man, tell the people what's been going on with your brother and what you've been up to, man. I saw you kill. We didn't see interview 103 doing your thing.
Oh man.
Yeah. What you been up to, brother?
Hey man, just working, man, trying to keep things moving forward, man. Got a few things going. Got my consulting firm, Crush Consulting. And,
I like that name.
Oh, back. Yeah. Yeah, it's a storyteller myself. We got a company together. And we work with a lot of artists. We worked with Miss Mulatto, Music Soul Child, a lot of people. Jay Farrell, Michael Blue, who else, baby? And then we do a lot of consulting. A lot of consulting for a lot of people. So the list goes on. Rolling out a lot of people.
Do you have to do a lot of traveling with that?
Yeah. We travel a lot, man. We just recently put Snoop in a Star Trek movie, and we just, we're just working, man. We're doing a lot. We just got back from L.A., so we've been out there for a few weeks.
Okay.
And we're back.
From 2003, when you just jumped on the scene the way you did, to now, what have you seen that's been the biggest change in the music industry? Because, you know, people always try to quote you as saying that you don't like this era of music, you know. What has changed in your opinion? You can clear it up now.
Yeah. I think everything has changed, and everything does change. It doesn't matter what it is, man. You know, we don't wear Lee jeans no more, but they didn't like them. So everything changes. You know?
Yeah.
Whether we think it's good or bad, it changes. So I don't think music has changed. It has too much accessibility that it didn't have back in the day.
Mm.
And you know, people are not respecting the fact that music, our music is our music, and we are now dumbing down the one thing that has made all of us be able to live in a way where we don't have to work a 9-to-5 in order to get money and be legit with it. And I think that the only problem is that the kids don't understand the importance of black music to us. Mm. And they made it to where we don't even think it's worthy enough to pay for. Now we're losing. Entertainment has always been our thing. From the beginning of time, that's what has helped us be able to get richer and richer and wealthier. You know, it would be no Puffy without music. It would be no Jay-Z without music. It would be no Stevie Wonder without music. So these things are very essential to our growth and our love. And a lot of those things are being taken for advantage now. That even me, you know, I buy music all the time, but I still buy music because I respect the fact that I know that if I don't pay for it, nobody else will pay for it,
right,
and I'll be on the street. Right. So it's a situation, just like in sports, and you guys are sports writers, if you start taking for granted that, you know, this is just whatever, eventually this job will go away.
Right.
And that job is what helps support your household, your family, your wife, and your kids. And that's the only thing I can see the difference between then and now is that, you know, music has now become cliche. It's just not a... it's not a viable source of life for a lot of our people.
Mm.
That's my only thing.
That was beautifully said, man. Let me ask you this. I always like to ask people when they create something of iconic stature, like Never Scared.
Huh.
Did you see it where even if you play it now in an arena or a club,
they just go crazy.
Something. Mm. When y'all was in that studio making this magic.
You make me want to take my shirt off still.
When that was happening, did you say, man, you know, this song gonna be lifetime. This lifetime iconic right here.
Negative.
You see what I'm saying? That's what killed me about artists.
No. I mean, it felt good. I mean, the record feels good. I mean, as long as it feels good, you know it has the potential to be great. But I never thought the record was going to be. But as I was putting it together, you know, as I was kind of, you know, I went and got Chip and Killer got on the record and kind of masterminded. And when we put it together, I knew it was something. Because I knew it was something. Not that I knew it was going to blow up like that. Yeah, it never got hold of me. Come on, I listen to it. I listen to it every day. I listen to music every day to see if it gets old. If it gets old to me, it's whack. I mean, even if I like it initially, if I listen to it over and over and over and over and over, because you got to realize you're going to get on a playlist at some point, and if it starts to die on you, and you made it, it's like, it's whack. You didn't make it. It ain't going to make it. But, you know, I knew the record. Still this day, if it come on, it don't sound old to me.
We threw a playoff party last year. Mm-hmm. And the Falcons were winning, about to go to the Super Bowl. Mm-hmm. The song, come on, place went
easy. People just started running around.
I mean, it went crazy. And I'm like, Bone put this together long. I mean, this is a test of
four times during the Super Bowl. Four times.
Yes. I mean, just, I don't have that. We don't have that. So we have to, you know, ask guys like you. When you like you said, it doesn't get old. Like we say, the deal on three, people standing up when they hear this song. Right. It just, I can't fathom it. And then how does it make you feel as an artist?
I feel honored. You know, I don't really feel nothing from it. I mean, I feel love. I love that more than anything. The music is whatever, because the music transcends and it does what it's supposed to do. And the feeling that I get to retort is what I love. But how the way you guys explain it, that's the love. I love that. The song itself is what it's supposed to be. I don't know. But the actual feeling that it gives people is what you go for as an artist.
Right.
You know, like a painting. You know, if I paint something and somebody look at me like, man, that's black. Yeah. You're like, oh, well, it didn't work. you gotta have to paint. You have to try to figure
try
it out.
Try again.
Because at the end of the day, it's a great product. It has to be a great product. And that's why it took me so long to come back out. I got two albums coming out this year. And one of them is Project 143, Storytelling Myself. And that's a love album a love story between me and her. And then I have another album coming out with me and Petey Pablo. It's called BoneCrusher. Petey Pablo presents Barry Hughes and Bobby Green, which is our alter egos.
Right.
You know, so we've been working, man. We got a lot of people on the albums, both albums. Music Soul Child on the Project 143 album. We got Glenn Jones. We got who else is over there? CeeLo Green. Dana Name. Who else is on there? And you know, on the Petey Pablo album, we got Charlotte Red did two songs on it.
That's gonna be hot. Jazzy Gray did two songs
on it. We got Killer Mike on the album. We got T.I. We got Scotty ATL. Carlos Miller's doing a bunch of skits on the album. We got Jay Farrell on the album. So it's a collaboration of great stuff that we're putting together. So I hope everybody loves it.
It's awesome.
We love it to death.
So stay with that real quick, because you just said something that really makes me happy. Mm-hmm. Skits. Mm-hmm. Back when the music was truly creative, mm-hmm. that was the big part of the album, mm-hmm. transitioning from song to song. You mm-hmm. got to get a skit in there.
You got to.
And I think, and it's funny you said something earlier about this, the younger guy, they don't take the time to understand how to craft a true album.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, and the thing is that the only problem, you're right, and the only problem that we have now that we didn't have back then, it's a double-edged sword, but that the kids now can put their very first record that they ever made in their life out.
Right.
Or have somebody say, nah, that's whack, don't put that out, and they don't have no other way to do it. They got to come through a gatekeeper or somebody that understands the music business or something of that nature. Yeah. Whereas now, because of social media, it's once again, double-edged sword. Social media is making it where you make a beat, doom, 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 you can put that out. And it's 7 billion people in the world. There is some group of clowns that's gonna like, doo, 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 and it's millions of them. Listen to me, Desmond. It's millions of people that like do do do. Doesn't mean it's jamming. It's just that there's so many people in the world, and you gotta realize there's 7 billion of us on this small planet that we call Earth, and there are people out here that like whack. It happens.
Some of y'all like.
You know, some people like whack. You know, it's like you go in the store, right? There's a selection there for a reason. You go to Nike. They don't just have Jordans on that wall. They got all kind of shit. That you like some of them shoes, you'd be like, man, who the hell is buying this garbage?
Somebody has it.
You know what I mean? You're like, man, well, damn, shit. Somebody buying it, you know?
Yeah.
But you have the nighttime, see some of them shoes with the sock connected to the bottom of the shoe, you'd be like, man, who is buying this? And there's some guy. Comes in and just buys it. And another guy comes in and buys it. Before you know it, they have an inventory of people buying these type of stuff. And you know, it's just that, and you don't have enough. You have enough quality out there, you just have to go get it. I find it myself. I go find the stuff I like.
Right.
You know, that's a great thing about social media and technology today. You can find great artists if that's what you're looking for. It's like when I go in the mall, I go looking for what I want. I go right past all the garbage, all the stuff that's trending. I don't do that. I go right to the stuff that I like.
Classic.
Buy it. And, you know, that's the problem that a lot of these young artists get. And it's not their fault. They do what they love. They do what they like. They're doing that. Doesn't mean I gotta like it.
Yeah.
I go buy the stuff that I like. I'm not gonna bash it because that's their thing. But, you know, I like to put together great albums. We like to put together great albums with skits and a great project. We like to make Rolls Royces. We're not into the Nissan market. We're not into the Yugo market. We're not into that. We're into Rolls Royces, Benzes, and Range Rovers. We're into that market. That's the market I want to be in.
Real quick, we finish with this BoneCrusher. I've heard about it. I talked to you a little bit about it. Heard you can throw down with that mac and cheese.
Oh, yeah.
Talk about that, man, and how you get down with it.
I mean, you know, I got a mac and cheese business that I used to be a chef for many years. I was on Food Network and doing a lot of stuff. But the whole thing is that we have this macaroni and cheese business. We have shrimp macaroni and cheese. We have crab and lobster macaroni and cheese. We also have beef, country sausage, chicken, salmon, which is one of our big sellers. And it's all about the sauce. It isn't really about the cheese. The reason why people like it so much is because of the sauce that I put in there. It's a recipe that I cultivated over the years. I perfected it. And me and my wife, we just make it. Whenever somebody asks for it, everybody that asks for it goes crazy over it. It's probably the best macaroni cheese you ever had in your life. I'm not going to say probably. It is the best macaroni cheese you ever had in your life.
I'm home now.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I should have brought something in. You should have told me.
So we about to end it, man, because me and May still feel like we got to go get some meat now.
Don't be scared.
Thank you, BoneCrusher. Tell them where they can find out more about you, man.
Oh, you can find me on all my social media pages, the double-edged sword again. Real BoneCrusher on my Instagram. Our Love is my Facebook. And Planet Crusher is my Twitter. Look for me on there, man. I'm available. You know, look out for my girl, too, Storyteller, on all facets. It's Storytellah. And we working, man.
We working.
Look out for the new singles, man, from both projects. Petey Pablo, BoneCrusher, and Storyteller, and BoneCrusher Project 143, man. And Michael Blue, look out for Michael Blue new album. New single called Blue God is playing right now, Q100. Crazy.
My boy Maceo, I guess BoneCrusher. I'm E. Glaze. Thank you guys. Watch Rolling Out with the Crush. Sports Meets Entertainment. We'll see you guys next week.
See you next week.
Peace.